Let me ask you a question. Do you know that feeling that after you play for weeks, for months, you don't feel that you're getting better? You feel like you're in a plateau? You know, do you know that feeling? I know that feeling. But probably what is happening is that you don't differentiate playing and practicing. And playing, it's not practicing. Okay, so that's very important. So I want to do this video to talk about playing and practicing. So first of all, playing is the most important thing, mainly when you're a beginner, and then you have just to connect with your instrument, you just have to have fun and play as many hours as you can, jam with the backing tracks, play, you know, the songs that you like, sing, whatever, just spend time with the instrument. But there's going to be a moment that you have to practice. And what I mean by practicing is you have to look at your mistakes, you have to analyze and be critical and start correcting mistakes and try to play more advanced stuff slowly and giving feedback all the time. So let's say you saw a video of a cool guitar player playing some kind of cool arpeggios with string skipping and you want to try that. And so you have to practice, because if you just play, probably you're never gonna improvise or play something like that just out of the bat, right? So let's say you're gonna play here like E minor arpeggio. So it's not super complicated, but it's not as easy as playing just a pentatonic, right? Because we have some string skipping. So let's see the most difficult part of that arpeggio, right? So we have two notes here, and then you skip one string and go to the next G string here. So that's the difficult part. So when you're practicing, you have to focus on that problem here, which is the string skipping. So up, down. So we have to think 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, right? And then 1, 2, 1. So we can do 1, 2, wait, think, position your finger, and then play. Right? Very slowly. And then you have the same problem here. So you can always play like wait, think, play the difficult movement. Wait, play the difficult movement. Until it's more fluent. So if you want to go up, so this string skipping here, right? So give some time for you to think, and then you're able to play the arpeggio flawless, right? With no, not hitting other strings or whatever, you know. And after you master the movement, then you can start trying to play faster. So that's practicing. I'm not playing on top of any backing track. I'm not trying to jam with that arpeggio with my friends. No, I'm just like really concentrating on the movement. If the, you know, the down, up, string skipping, down, up, string skipping, down, up, really like focusing on the movement. And then after, another way of practicing is also analyzing the notes, the intervals, right? So you have the tonic, the minor third, the seventh, the tonic. So we have E, 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 right? Octaves, and the minor third, the seventh, and the fifth here. Okay, so now you know where are those intervals. So if you want to play major, it's not a problem. And then major seventh. I can put the major seventh here too if I want. The technical part is the same, right? Two notes per strings, two notes per string, string skipping. It's the same technical situation, but changing the note. So now you can play major, you can play minor, you can play major with the minor seventh. You can try to play the half diminished, right? It's just a flat fifth. And the diminished as well. So diminished the seventh. So now you're analyzing the intervals, trying to understand the sound, and then you can even create the entire exercise from major to diminished. Right, so now you have an exercise, you really paid attention on the movement and the technical part. This is practicing. Now, after you play that for 20 minutes, half hour, 1 hour, I don't know, but doesn't need to be a very long, because it's very hard to have focus for such a long time, more than an hour. Then you go and start playing with your backing tracks or playing with your band, with your friends. And then you try to improvise, and now you're playing, and then you try to connect with yourself, you know, with your intuition, with your musicality, and just try to connect that those exercises, those arpeggios, into whatever jam track you have, right? And maybe it's in E minor, maybe it's E major, maybe it's a G major. So start experimenting. So now it's, when you're playing, it's not the time to be very analytic. It's not good to be, you know, compare yourself to other players or is it good or not. So that's not the time. Just get the flow, just play, and then if you have the technique, if you know already the major, the minors, the diminished, so you're good to go to play. And then you play for a long time and just try to improvise on top of those exercises that you practice. Got it? So I hope this video is useful for you. So leave your comments. Please ask as many questions as you want so I can do more videos based on your questions. Subscribe to the channel. Activate the notifications, right? So this is very important, so I get more excited to do more videos like this. And see you on the next video.